I'm satisfied with the part, let's put it that way. I don't know if I've ever been happy with a video part. I think I always just have to accept what it is, and then later on, like a year or two later, I'll look at it and I'll be happy with it. And it's weird because I have this longing to accomplish my goals, and even though the deadline has passed, I still want to accomplish them, but then I don't even know what I'm going to do with it. And then I don't know if I should film it VX or HD, because what's it going to go towards, you know? I think that filming VX is a statement at this point. I feel like it's hard to do, and you know, it's not convenient, but I feel like the footage has an essence of what our company was built on and what type of skating I think is Zero. So to answer your question very simply, Zero will film VX until it's no longer possible. I feel like at any given time in skateboarding, or in any industry for that matter, there's things that you might not necessarily like about it. And if you obsess about those things, then you could sit around and just talk about how terrible it is and it'll make you just want to go away. I feel like there's a lot of things going on, whether they be contests or big corporate stuff or whatever it is. That stuff's awesome, but I feel like it's in almost like a parallel industry going alongside of the industry that I see. The industry I see is like working with our team and trying to like do rad shit with this group of dudes that just love it more than anything on the planet, you know? And I feel like, I don't know, man, I feel like if you're not out there skating and you're not living skateboarding like in the streets, then like what are you doing here? You're just taking up space or whatever, you know? So I just want to do that. And I've gone through phases of being like involved in business and focused on business and not in the streets and whatnot, but I'll tell you, I feel the best when I'm out skating and when I'm like focused on a video, or I'm doing what I did in 1997 or 8. You know, that's where I feel most comfortable, and that's what I'm trying to get back to. I'm trying to like pull myself a little bit out of like behind the scenes business and just be an ambassador for these brands and be a skateboarder, you know, and be an ambassador for skateboarding. I mean, I think that from all the Zero riders from the past, I'm probably closest with Ellington or Adrian Lopez. You know, it's hard. I get really inspired by all the guys that rode for Zero, you know, like Greco's part in the Death Wish video I thought was fascinating. I thought like how obsessive he was about learning all these like crazy tricks, and it's awesome, you know, and then, so I don't know, it's hard to say, you know. You know, it's someone though that I feel like their time on Zero was cut really, really short, and I wish it was longer, was Trainwreck. I feel like he was only on for like the smallest blip of time, and he made such a huge impact, and he was so gnarly. And it would have been rad to be able to see like that full video part from Trainwreck. He was supposed to be in Dying to Live, and I wish that would have happened. That was his In Bloom part, and I wish that would have happened, and that, I think that would have been a game changer, and I would have loved to have seen it. I might just edit it someday. Forrest Edwards is awesome. I originally saw the Slap One in a Million Things and thought the kid was terrible because he was saying all these things that I felt were just rude and disrespectful to skateboarding as a whole. And like at first I was just intrigued by how insane he was and how, you know, like, I don't know, self-absorbed he was, and he was just all about winning, and it was just crazy, and it just kind of spun me out. But then I found myself like kind of getting into him being a villain and like really appreciating the fact that he was just honest. And then when I got to meet him, it was even more awkward than watching him on film, because he's kind of a socially awkward person. But then I kind of started like developing like this strange fascination with his awkwardness and with him as a person. And over time, like it gave me an appreciation for Forrest. And basically he just loves skating, and he just has like a drive to just progress and do rad stuff and get gnarly. Once you get to know Forrest and you get past the like kind of like, you know, macho, like I'm the best thing, he's a really rad dude, and he's just a kind of a normal skate rat, and he just loves skating, and he knows what everybody did everywhere, and he's constantly comparing like what he could do to what other people did, because he wants to progress, he wants to push himself. He just doesn't, he's not very eloquent with his words, so he doesn't really know how to say it in a way that's acceptable. So he just says it how he feels it, and it just freaks everybody out. And I think that's kind of sick too. It's like skateboarding needs people like Forrest Edwards.